Hello and welcome to another Cool Kingdom unboxing video. Today we are taking a look at Flames of Destruction, another new Yu-Gi-Oh! Set bringing some cool topologic cards, the element sabers, and tons of fantastic support, especially the nightmares, which are due to set off pretty much every combo that you can possibly imagine in the future. So without further ado, let's open up this box. So we can see a topologic Trisbane on the front here. The usual just continued artwork on the sides and the classic silver back that we have here. So let's delve into the box. This is a standard booster box, so we have 9 cards per pack and 24 packs in this box. We're going to be taking a look at one half, then a quick break before we move on to the second half. So let's bring in the camera a little bit closer here so that you can take a nice look at the cards once we start opening up these packs. So we kick things off with a Trickstar Nightshade, Mech Knight Avrim, Altergeist Cadolga, Watchcat, Heartless Drop-Off as the rare, and Element Saber Nalu as the super rare. If we bring this a little bit more into focus, it's a little bit better. Then we have a Protron, Staring Contest, although you could technically go with Staring because it is the I believe it's the Sorceress here. Then we have a Gookie Bear Hug. Then a Kaiden Kendo Spirit, Restoration of the Monarchs, so basically a Monster Reborn for your big Monarchs, a Defrag Dragon, Gookie Face Turn, Element Saber Malihu for the Ultra, then Crystal Master, finally getting in this Crystal support here, a Yajiro Invader, really funny card, Altergeist Pixiel, a Battery Man Solar. Then we have Called by the Grave, so the common print of this card. Crystal Keeper, Gookie Octo Stretch, a Vendread Nightmare, World Legacy World Lance as the rare, and World Legacy Sorrow as the super. So this is pretty interesting. You get to negate a spell trap or monster, a spell trap card or a monster effect while you control a co-link monsters. Monster or monsters. Then Trickstar Blue, Zekta Pico Felina, and Crystal Conclave. Then another Element Saber, this time Marlo, World Legacy's Corruption, another Nightshade, Heartless Drop-Off, a Link Bound as our super, then an Aina, an Emolite Elf for your Altergeist new trap, a Vendread Daybreak, Link Streamer as the final card in that pack. Then we have another Cadolga, a Trolling Trolls, a Kendo Spirit, Tendangle Trinity, Sekka's Light. I'm amazed they printed this as a rare, actually, basically pot agreed for any monster heavy decks. Really nice to see. Then we have a Nightmare Griffin as the first secret rare. Let's see if we can get that holofoil technology coming up a little bit better. You can see the polarized pixels here. Really, really nice. This is basically a combo extender for a ton of decks and enables you to set floodgates. By sending them to the grave with something like Curious, and then using this card to set them again, it's really, really crucial for some awesome combos that are going to be coming up in the future. So fantastic pull there. Then we have a Transfamiliar, a Protron, and Altergeist Pixiel. A Watchcat here, a Space Insulator, Restoration of the Monarchs, Trickstar Light Arena, so a new field spell for them, and a D-grade Buster here for the super, a Cybersal Cyclone, Flower Cardian Moonflower Viewing, a Trickstar Mandrake, and another Bear Hug. Next up, Shadow Construct. So they went with actually using the same name here. So there are two cards with Construct, within the title. However, note it's missing the L, so if you do ask your opponent what Shadol Construct does, they can just tell you the effect of this card. So a new link for that archetype. Then we have a Gooky Octo Stretch, FA Dead Heat, Mech Knight Avram, Trickstar Delphindium, interesting name there, an Element Saber Lapuila, Revendred Evolution, so this is kind of like Shadol Fusion for your Ritual spell, this is pretty cool, Transfamiliar, and World Legacy's Nightmare. Then another Watch Cat, F.A. Dead Heat, Caught by the Grave, Heartless Drop, an Altergeist Multifigure as an Ultra. This is really good. Very useful within the deck, enabling you to spam out monsters much, much more quickly. Kind of makes the deck reach the competitive standpoint that it wasn't quite at before. Then a Crystal Conclave, Trickstar Bloom, Vendred Daybreak, and Crystal Master. Let's see if we can get some more Nightmare cards from this set. A Restoration of the Monarchs, a Gurgon's End, we have a Mamemaki, Element Saber Malo, a Trickstar Delphindium, a Trickstar Rodode, a Trickstar Mandrake, Link Streamer, and Limit Code. Then a Tindangle Trinity, Mech Knight Avram, Defrag Dragon, a Nightmare Mermaid. This is really good because your opponent is probably going to give you the other secret, which is Nightmare Ibley, and then using this enables you to carry on playing the game, basically, so really useful. Then we have an Element Saber Lapuila Mana, Pixiel, another Cyclone, another Bear Hug, and another Emolite Elf. Then we have Prompthorn, a Kendo Spirit, Dead Heat, another Restoration, a Great Fly, so your generic Wind Link 2, really cool to see. Then Super Team Buddy Force Unite as a second secret from the set. So already within one half we've seen two secrets. Does that mean that we're not going to see another one in the second half? Or are we going to see three secrets from this set? Really nice artwork. I'm not a huge fan of the card itself, but still it's a secret and it looks gorgeous. Then Element Saber Aina, Battery Man Solar, and Yajiro Invader. And the last pack from this side of the box, we have another Mamemaki, then Altergeist Kadoga, World Legacy's Corruption, a Trickstar Light Arena, another Linkbound, Protron, Background Dragon, Trickstar Mandrake, and a Vendred Daybreak. So we'll take a quick break here and move on to the second half of the box. So onto the second half of this box, let's see if we can get another secret from it. Or maybe just some nice ultras. So we have a Majolte Fresh Sistrat, a Gurgon's End, Crystal Keeper, Trickstar Bouquet, an Element Saber Makani, then Insecta Picafalina, Limit Code, Waking the Dragon, this is really cool, and Boycotton. So Waking the Dragon there, allowing you to summon pretty much any monster you want from your extra deck. Then a Nightshade, Mamemaki, Monster Reborn Reborn. This is really cool. A Vendred Nightmare. F.A. Dark Dragster. A Phosphorage, the Elemental Lord. So another Elemental Lord to go with the Element Sabers. An Emerald Elf. A Moonflower Viewing. And a Bear Hug. Then a Promthorn. Space Insulator. Three Trolling Trolls. F.A. Overheat. World Legacy Sorrow as Super. Another Revolution. Evolution, sorry. Transfamiliar. A Nightmare. And a Background Dragon. Then Red-Haired Hasty Horse. Dolce Fresh Sistart. Altergeist Kadoga. Gergen's End. Gooky Face Turn. A D-Grade Buster. Limit Code. Battery Man Solar. And another Picofilina. I'm not sure that Picofilina is really enough to invite Insectus back into the meta, but who knows what will happen in the upcoming format. So we have a Mech Knight Avram, a Mallow, Mamamaki, another Seeker's Light, really good to get this as well, a Nightmare Cerberus, so this is another one of these new generic Nightmare monsters, really easy to make, they're fantastic Ling archetypes, definitely worth picking up these guys if you can. Cybersal Cyclone, Crystal Master, a Staring Contest, and a Link Streamer. Then Trolling Trolls, World Legacy's Corruption, Shadow Construct, a Tindangle Trinity, another Overheat, another Phosphorage, another Bear Hug, Moonflower Viewing, and another Background Dragon. Then a Fresh Sistart, Nightshade, a Nightmare, a Promthorn, another Dark Dragster, another Cerberus, so really good to get the second copy of that, that'd be pretty useful. Then a Master, another Evolution, and Transfamiliar. Another Kendo Spirit, Trolling Trolls, Space Insulator, Heartless Drop-Off. Then we have Iron Dragon Timaton. So this you summon into a zone that I think has three or more cards within it, and then you get to pop every single one of them, so this is really cool to see. Then a Staring Contest, another Bloom, an Aina, and Cybersal Cyclone. Then Octo Stretch, Defrag Dragon, Called by the Grave, another Construct, Greatfly, a Gooky the Master Ogre, so advancing even further into the Gooky archetype. You only need 2 plus Gooky monsters, but it is a Link 4, so you can use your like Link 3 with a Link 1, a Link 1 or with a just typical monster. That's pretty cool to see. World Legacy's Nightmare, Battery Man Solar, and Yajiro Invader. Keeper, Monster Reborn Reborn, Red-Haired Hasty Horse, World Legacy Struggle, another Phosphorage, so we have a playset of Phosphorages from this set, then another Emerald Elf, Protron, Link Streamer, and Revendred Evolution. Are we going to sneak in a third secret from the set? We have a Watch Cat, Space Insulator, Element Saber Mallow, Defrag Dragon, a Nightmare Mermaid, a Rainbow Refraction here, really cool artwork on this, a Transfamiliar, a Mandrake, and Daybreak, and for the final pack, what can we get? So we have Called by the Grave, Avram, a Tindangle Trinity, another Seeker's Light, a full playset of Seeker's Light, that's really good. And then a wind-up Zen Maintenance R. So no third secret from this box, but a really nice super enabling wind-ups to actually do something a little bit more than what they were capable of doing before. So really great upgrade for them, basically. Trickstar Bloom, an Element Saber Aina, and Altergeist Pigseal, and finally a Protron. So that's it for this box. Let's take a quick look at the cards which were ultra or higher rarity. So that's it for this Flames of Destruction unboxing. We've got some really cool cards in here, some great new archetypal stuff, and the Nightmares look absolutely amazing, plus the Element Saber stuff is really cool too, definitely worth giving a try. So let's take a look at the Ultras and above that we got here. So we start off with Element Saber Makani. This is basically the Search of the deck, really, really cool looking card. Then a Malihu, which is another Element Saber. This is kind of like a quick play effect to set your opponent's monsters. So it's a bit like Snow, a bit like Book of Moon. And then we have Iron Dragon Tiamaton. So being able to pop up to, three or more cards at a single point, and then locking your opponent out of a bunch of zones as well with this effect. Really, really cool. Then Altergeist Multifaker. So the new, really powerful main deck monster for the Altergeist archetype, enabling them to spam out monsters way, way faster than before, and setting up some really cool stun aspects as well. For the secrets, we got Super Team Buddy Force Unite, an interesting, fairly generic card, and some really, really funky artwork on here as well. Plus, it looks absolutely gorgeous in the secret rare version. And finally, we have Nightmare Griffin, so the combo extender that enables you to basically set any floodgate you want in something like a 60-card deck, potentially ABC variants as well. Definitely worth checking out the combos that this card can achieve, because it's really fantastic. And it also locks your opponent out of using the effects of special summon monsters that aren't linked. Really, really important, and a phenomenal card as well. So this has been a really great set. Be sure to pick up your own box of Flames of Destruction from our website today. There's a link to the Core Kingdom website in the description down below. Maybe you'll be able to pick up the cover card, the Topologic Trisbana, from the set when you pick up your own box. And also, the singles for the set will be up on the website very soon as well. As always, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to check out our other unboxings, and I'll see you guys in the next one.